This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
What's up, Wisconsin? You're listening to Raised in Wisco. I'm your host, Joel Clayfish. This is Danielle Fairman,
Hello.
The sidekick with the mostest, running around the state of Wisconsin with me, hunting, fishing, and living
every day.
Loving every day, man.
Jinx.
I am so excited because we love it that you join us here on Civic Media and the Civic Media family throughout the state of Wisconsin. On 13 stations throughout the state, you can hear us on Saturday mornings at 11 a.m. on your Civic Media station anywhere in Wisconsin. And I don't think, Danielle, that we have ever had this abundant of a celebrity panel for the show.
This show is
going to go so fast that it's going to be the speed of light. I am so excited about it. I'm going to start with the Weekly Wisco and get the introductions
because we are not
going to have enough time
to
motor through this. This is very exciting. The Foul Life national television show, which airs on the Outdoor Channel and My Outdoor TV, starring Chad Belding. And folks, if you listen to the show, you know I have the honor, the privilege, and the fun of being the Midwest host of The Foul Life. We talk about it on the show quite a bit. Well, The Foul Life's entire crew, national crew, is here in Wisconsin, working on Travel Wisconsin, hunting. We are eating. We're hitting supper clubs and Harley Davidson and everything that makes Wisconsin great. And it's fantastic. But it will blow your mind what hunting and the outdoor culture of the great state of Wisconsin brings together when it talks about a dichotomy of people. Tuffy Stone is here in the studio with us. He's the six-time world barbecue champion pitmaster. He's unbelievable. And of course, he came in to hunt with us. And we're going to have an incredible time with him. Denny Reed is here from Maryland. He invented Camo Space. I cannot wait. I'm so excited to tell you all about Camo Space. It is like the Instagram, Facebook for hunters, outdoors folks, and he's the inventor of it. And it is a way to get on the internet and express your truest side when it comes to enjoying the outdoors of the great state of Wisconsin and this country. Denny Reed is here in person. Cody Stamen, UFC featherweight fighter, is in the studio with us. I mean, boom. This blows my mind, Danielle.
Yeah, it's a pretty exciting crowd, and I have questions for every single one of you, so I do not know who we're going to start with first.
Yeah, this show's going to move, I'll tell you that. And of course, my good friend, who will forevermore be wearing alligator cowboy boots.
I saw that on Facebook.
And presented him for his 50th birthday. He doesn't look a day past 49, does he?
Not a day past 49. Look at you go.
Anyway, Chad's in the studio with us too. And I want to get, I don't think our Weekly Wisco is that these guys are in town. And I want to start off with Tuffy Stone. I mean, this will never be repeated. You won the Jack Daniels three times. You're the six-time world champion pitmaster. I tell everybody, Raised in Wisco, at the end of the day, is about cooking. It's a cooking show because we always end up talking about food. You are the guru. You are the master. Your nickname is The Professor. Talk to me about barbecue.
I'm just so glad that this is radio and not television because I'm really blushing over here. My grandfather beat my head humility, so you've embarrassed me.
It will be on Facebook, so everyone will be able to watch it on Facebook.
Oh, great,
so
look great, at you great, go. Great.
Don't worry, I have you covered, Tuffy.
Right.
Tuffy, you are very clearly a humble man, but one of the things we've talked about already is the connection between the outdoors and barbecue. Barbecue is really this kind of fundamental, basic way of cooking that I think is natural and innate in all of us. How did you, as a hunter, as a pit master, as a barbecue man, how does that all wrap itself together?
You know, I just thought back to one of my first culinary experiences. I was probably about, I don't know, 15, 16 years old, and I cooked my first version of surf and turf, and it was squirrel.
Squirrel?
That I... It was squirrel.
Like squirrel brain or situation? No,
they look like rats in the skillet, but anyways.
But you had a rat in the skillet?
It was a squirrel. But, and some brook trout that I had caught myself. So that was my, but you know, we were on the drive over here for the show. We were talking and Chad was asking, is there a lot of commonality with barbecuers in the same way when we get together as hunters and people that fish? And I think it's the exact same thing. There's this camaraderie that comes along with getting out in the woods and going hunting, or, you know, getting out on the boat and going fishing, or lighting up the barbecue pit and cooking some meat.
I want to ask you a fundamental question that I think a lot of people end up having a kind of line between, and that is, is barbecue as good of a medium for cooking food that is wild game versus store-purchased meat? Can you cross that over and take a recipe that is for store-purchased meat or procured meat and turn it into the wild protein meat? Is it same, or do you have to make some changes when you do that?
Well, I think you got to make some adjustments. I think first, let's just define what barbecue is. And I'm going to say that barbecue in this case is anything that's cooked with fire and outdoors. We'll make it outdoor and fire. So, you know, one of the things that's really important to me, and I think some of the poor attempts that people make when you make barbecue the very first time, is we put too much smoke on it. We oversmoke it. Another thing that we tend to do with, you know, some of your commodity meats is we undercook it. Nobody likes tough barbecue. Mm-hmm. But one of the things when I was working on my cookbook and developing a lot of recipes, I found when I'm cooking the game that I've harvested, whether it be goose or duck or venison, quail, dove, is I don't want to overcook it. So one of the things that I really got to keep in check, venison was a really great thing that I learned, you know, even the tough cuts of venison, you know, one of the quarters, if I cooked it too much, the texture wasn't right, the gaminess got a little bit stronger.
And so, by too much, what do you mean? Like too long, like leaving on there, isn't it low and slow and forever? Because I'm asking all these questions, I suck at it.
Well, it depends on what cut we're talking about. We're talking about a backstrap, and it's going to barely kiss the fire. You know, it's going to be, you know, when it comes to duck breast or goose, I'm going to probably cook that to where it's not going to get any hotter than 130 degrees. Mm-hmm. Now, when we get into like shoulders and hindquarters, that's a tougher cut of meat, and I'm going to cook it longer to break it down to where it gets tender.
Now, what about a turkey, since Thanksgiving's right around the corner?
Well, so I'm a big, you know, anybody that knows me and has paid much attention to the way I cook, I'm a big fan of brine. So I like to brine a lot. I've developed a lot of brine recipes. And with, you know, turkeys, I am definitely going to soak them in a brine.
Perfect.
But I don't want to overcook that turkey. nope. I think everybody can relate to an overcooked dry turkey.
Absolutely.
One of the questions that comes up a lot, I mean, I'm a cook. I would call myself an armchair cook.
I saw your
cook.
Pantry. You're a cook. I saw your freezer.
I'm an armchair cook. You know, I'm not trained. I learned through osmosis through my little Italian mother, who put gnocchis together with wild game and pork roast and homemade cannolis last night. I never was taught anything. I learned just from watching, and I have a little bit of an ability to know what something's going to taste like when it's done. What do you say to those people who are kind of afraid to get into it? Because this show, and the reason we love our audience on Raised in Wisco and the Civic Media family, is because we love to show people they are capable of taking that first step to do anything. People who haven't experienced the outdoors, people who don't know the things that are available to them in Wisconsin, if they travel Wisconsin, what they can do, from rock climbing to kayaking to barbecuing to camping to hunting to fishing. Everybody has that point in their life where they're just afraid to cross that starting line. What do you say to the new barbecuer, the person who's never done it before? What's the best and easiest way to get into it?
You know, I teach people all the time at all different levels. And I'd say, first of all, don't be scared. You know, have fun. And even if we make a mistake, you know, those are the teaching blocks to make us do it better next time. You know, I've got some simple rules when it comes to barbecue. Overs beat unders. Nobody likes tough barbecue, so I'm going to probably try and cook it till it's really tender. I would, you know, some of the guiding lights for me that have helped me find so much success in cooking. Treat smoke like salt and pepper. The best foods in the world are going to have the best tenderness. So, you know, work on that perfect doneness. We can always put it back on the grill. We can always cook it a little bit more. And flavor, you know, salt is your friend.
I'm so excited. Tuffy Stone's going to be cooking with us in Duck Camp. And I want to tell you, this is going to be so exciting because we have the freshest potential protein to use. We literally harvested the ducks and the geese that you are going to be using to cook tomorrow. We were harvesting them today. It doesn't get any better than that, any fresher than that. Chad Belding, host of The Fowl Life. Absolutely awesome to have you in the studio with us. Is this the first time you're eating food that Tuffy Stone has cooked before?
No, sir.
So tell me about, how did you guys meet and how does hunting end up with you allowed to meet these unbelievable people and we all end up sharing the qualities of our lives and our lives together?
The first company that we started was Bandit, and the our tagline was hunting is the common denominator that brings all these walks of life together. So you have a UFC fighter, you have a pit master, you have an entrepreneur, you have a farmer, and all of us share that love and that passion for the outdoors. So I always looked at it like it doesn't matter if you're a five-star general in the military or one of the best baseball players in the world. We've hunted with them all, country singers, actors, you name it. And, you know, we have been obliged and honored to develop a relationship with Jack Daniels out of Lynchburg, Tennessee. And the Jack, to me, is the most proclaimed barbecue championship title that you can win. It's an invitational only. You mentioned that Tuffy won it three times. Well, the Jack family invited me to the barbecue competition in Lynchburg the last several years. And I got to go behind the scenes with Tuffy, and I watched him start the fire. I will learn the story about Tuffy and his father. It was the first time he lit a fire without his father that year. Mm-hmm. The pictures that you see of Tuffy online with his father, he was his right-hand man. They were always side by side. So I took this love to Tuffy because I lost my father too. And to watch his passion for starting that fire and accomplishing what he did. And then I got to taste the food and I was like, I can't do this. So I was like, I have to challenge myself to get better. And the questions you're asking are awesome because it can be a barrier of entry to become a good barbecuer, but Tuffy Stone makes it very easy to learn.
Yeah, I can't wait. I honestly, the hair on my arms and my neck is standing up. And, you know, we do cooking segment every show, and Tuffy Stone is going to talk to us about that cooking segment. How exciting. We've got a fantastic cast of characters today. I'm Joel Clayfish. That is Danielle Fairman. This is Civic Media throughout the state of Wisconsin. Awesome. This is Raised in Wisco.
You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
Raised and Wisco, your one-stop shop for everything about the great outdoors of the great state of Wisconsin. Civic Media is your media outlet. You can hear us on 13 radio stations throughout the great state of Wisconsin, all the way from the tip of Lake Huron to the bottom of Wisconsin, where that line separates us from Bear Country. My name's Joel Clayfish. I'm the host of Raised in Wisco. Danielle Fairman is alongside me today.
Just laughing away.
What an exciting day. I honestly, I'm so jacked up. I don't do drugs, but I gotta imagine this is what it feels like.
Good for you. I'm glad you do not.
You're glad I don't do drugs?
Yes,
you're glad you do not do drugs. What it feels like. I'm so excited. We have got Tuffy Stone, six-time world barbecue champion pitmaster here. Denny Reed, inventor of Camo Space, who we're talking to now. And this is going to blow your mind because this is so exciting to me. I can't even tell you. We've got Cody Stamen, UFC, featherweight, fighter. He's going to be with us on the show. And of course, Chad Belding, national host of The Foul Life. The Foul Life's in town all week. We hunted this morning. We're going to literally take what we hunted this morning and cook it with a 6-time world champion pitmaster. How, if you're me and food
How
is your favorite dish,
still?
I'm kicking my leg. I'm like a weeble wobble. Do you remember those things when we were a little kid? I can't fall down. I am so excited. I'm
breathe,
so fired up.
Breathe.
I'm just going to take a minute. I'm going to take a minute. Jess, producer Jess, have I ever been this fired up during a show?
I don't think so. I don't think so. This is a new level I'm seeing.
What, you know, food is my favorite dish, right?
Yes, everybody knows. It's fantastic.
I mean, and
you made me love food.
We hunt, so I get to hunt with a guy who has the social media, has invented a social media platform that you can share all of your recipes, your outdoor adventures.
How do I not know about this?
Danielle, it's
raised
called
in
Camo
Wisco.
Space.
Right now.
And the inventor of it, Denny Reed, not only is he a serious hunter, because what I love about Wisconsin, the outdoors, and travel Wisconsin, and coming to Wisconsin, and raised in Wisco, is about showing you that you can have some excitement in your life that you may have never known, and it will fit, because there is no mold for a hunter. There is no mold for a forager who takes from the field to the table in some of the best culinary recipes you'll ever have in your life. To me, the eating of the wild game, the fresh, organic wild game, is just as important as the harvest of it. The sunrise is just as important as the pulling of the trigger. The camaraderie, the laughing. My stomach hurts from laughing so much.
That's perfect.
And I think it also hurts from the squats I was doing standing up in the blind.
Oh, yeah?
Because
you hurt your stomach doing squats?
Well, I don't know how
I did it.
Maybe it's more of a booty thing. Maybe it's just some... maybe it is more of a booty thing. I don't know. All I can say is it was very muddy, so our chairs were sunk in.
Oh,
and when we had
it.
To stand up to shoot, we had to really stand up. So to have these folks around me, you want to talk about using all the energy you have in your soul coming out all at once. And Denny Reed, the coolest thing about this dude, for real, is that he's like a gigantic watermelon farmer.
Watermelon?
In Maryland.
We grow a lot of watermelons.
And here's something that I don't think a lot of people, you're from Maryland.
From the Eastern Shore. I'm very clear about that.
From the Eastern Shore. Well, here's the craziest thing. You're going to hear.
I want to know stories about
the
other side.
We think of East Coasters as like, yo, Danny, get over here.
Yep.
Yeah, sit
down.
Well,
that's more of the Northeast.
You better talk to me the right way. You're going to find yourself in cement shoes.
That's New Jersey.
Yeah, okay. Well, but that's kind of what we think
cement
of.
Cement shoes gave it away.
That's kind of what we think of East Coasters. He's from the East Coast, but he's got a Southern accent, and he told me something I never knew. He lives in Maryland, south of the Mason-Dixon line.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
We're from the South.
Isn't that crazy? And you're a watermelon farmer.
Yeah. Well, just to refresh, a lot of people think of Baltimore and Washington when they think of Maryland. We're on the Eastern Shore between the ocean and the bay. So it's, if you got dropped in Illinois, you wouldn't know no difference. I mean, it's all farm country, good Southern people.
Yeah, it's fantastic. What I want to know, though, you as a farmer, so farmers procure the land. They are the ones who supply the food source for America. You're a big farmer. You've got hundreds of acres of farmland.
5,000
acres.
How many watermelon?
800 acres of watermelons. We usually ship around 1,000 tractor trailer loads in 60 days every year between July 15th and September 15th.
That's incredible. Huh. How did that marry with your passion and your love for hunting?
Well, because I grew up on a farm, and the greatest thing we could do was be able to get to go hunting, especially in the afternoons after school or in the fall when we got done harvest. I mean, it was just the most exciting time, and when rifle season was coming. And then we, you know, like goose and duck hunting, and that was the birthplace of waterfowl hunting is on the Eastern Shore. It's always been famous for duck and goose hunting out there.
And I'm going to ask this question in every segment with everyone we get. Chad Belding, national host of The Foul Life. I want you to tell me, how did you end up hunting with a watermelon farmer from Maryland? How did that come about?
We were lucky enough to be we have a partnership with a man named Art Tucker in Georgia, who owns a company called the 2-9, and he builds relationships for us. He's more of an agent, and he kind of took us into the realm of camo space, introduced us to Denny. I got to know Denny on a personal level. We've shared camp many times, and the more I learned about him, his farming operation, his passion for the outdoors, and what he was doing with camo space, it just made sense for us to get on board, and that's where the support came from.
Without a second more, let's understand what camo space is. How'd you come up with it? What is it, and what's its purpose?
I mean, it's very basic social media for the outdoors. If you love hunting, fishing, any outdoors, it's going to be camping, biking, hiking, whatever. So many times in the last 4 or 5 years, people have been censored. Something as simple as a father taking their son, killing a deer, and it gets taken off for sensitive content. We don't think that's sensitive content. I'm in control of it, so it'll never be banned or censored for putting up the lifestyle that we love. I originally had the ideas because there is a lot of hunting shows, like Chad's got himself, but not everybody can have a hunting show. But everybody's going to take a picture or a video while they're hunting, so it's a place you can post this yourself without, you know, you might not ever find yourself on national TV, but it's a place you can post and share it with your friends.
That's nice, because all the bashing you get on other social media sites are,
exactly.
Sometimes it gets a little too far, they cross the line, and I downloaded the app already, so it's that easy. I did it within seconds, and the first thing it says is Camo Space is a welcoming environment for the outdoor enthusiasts. All good reviews, thousands and thousands of good reviews. So,
and if you think about it, I mean, really, we've talked about this subject before. 99% of people are meat eaters in this world. And I support farmers, and I love our cow industry in Wisconsin. I love a good, beef steak for sure. But somebody who wants to harvest their own wild game, and they have a moment with their grandfather, a loved one, their granddaughter, a friend who's never hunted before in the outdoors, and they have a successful harvest. There are few things in the world more satisfying to do with someone else. And to be able to share that with other people in an unadulterated way, I think is priceless. I think you've really hit on something that's going to take off. I think you've hit on something that makes it comfortable and fantastic to celebrate that ethical field to table. And gosh, you're awesome. That's Camo Space. Go ahead, check it out. Get on it. Share your love of the outdoors.
Download the app.
We've got so much more. This is so great. Love having you on Raised in Wisco.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
Man, if Guns N' Roses does not get you fired up, I don't know what will. I don't know if I could get much more fired up about the panel we have. Folks, you're listening to Raised in Wisco. My name's Joel Clayfish, lifelong Wisconsin resident. I absolutely love the fact that we get to host a show. Danielle Fairman and I get to host a show called Raised in Wisco because I was raised in this state. And the beauty of this state is that not everybody knows what it has to offer, from hunting to fishing to kayaking, the best culinary in the entire United States, all in a massive melting pot here. Danielle, we're in the middle of the deer hunting season today.
We are.
Today, Saturday, is the opening of the gun deer season. 600,000 Wisconsinites in blaze orange, known as the Orange Army, hit the fields with firearms, and it's one of the safest events in the entire country, which just tells me we do it right here in Wisconsin.
We definitely do, and I do not know any other states that have that many. And it is all safe everywhere you go, and it's a big camaraderie for everybody involved.
I bet you Michigan would give you guys a run for your money. I think Michigan's pretty close.
I bet
I really do.
Yeah. I'm still gonna say that we are the best. Dang it!
I think we're the best. And I have to tell you, we have never had such a star-studded cast on Raised in Wisco as we have today. Tuffy Stone is here. He's the 6-time World Barbecue Champion Pitmaster, 3-time Jack Daniels winner. Denny Reed from Maryland. He's the starter, the founder, the inventor of Camo Space. Cody Stamen, a UFC featherweight fighter, and Chad Belding, national host of The Foul Life. The Foul Life is in town this week. We hunted successfully this morning. We're looking for some other hunts. This warm weather is blowing my mind.
Disgusting.
It's not making me happy. Now, not one bit. I know that there are plenty of Wisconsinites who would love to debate me on the fact that I am wishing for colder weather, but that's going to move those birds from Canada back to where we can hunt them again, because it has been rough.
It's been
a real lull here, and now we're shooting a waterfowl hunting television show.
Just start throwing some ducks in there.
It reminds me of the WKRP in Cincinnati, I Thought Turkeys Could Fly episode. Do you remember that? Anybody remember that?
Nope.
Where they dropped the frozen turkeys. They dropped the frozen turkeys out of a helicopter, and it didn't go well.
I can't imagine it would.
Cody Stamen, UFC fighter in the room with the pitmaster, with the inventor of Camo Space, Danielle Fairman, a heavy equipment operator. You got a former politician, current government affairs guy who gets to have this radio show Raised in Wisco. And I have to be honest, the common thread here is Chad Belding. Chad, you and I have known each other now for going on 4 years. I'd like to think that it's become it's blossomed into a very,
blossomed,
very wonderful,
very
friendship.
Manly word.
But I want to know what your secret is. I want to understand why I am now sitting next to a UFC fighter, a pit master, the inventor of a massive social media platform. How does
question.
It happen that we come together and are at this moment in history, at this time and place, together?
I think it comes down to that everybody's just like we are. You can be a celebrity, you know, like these guys are. I walk into a UFC fight with this guy right here. And when you walk in through the tunnel at the T-Mobile Arena, he cannot go to his seat because he's badgered for nonstop pictures, selfies, autographs. And he's just Cody to me, but he's literally, he's building a legacy as a fighter because he's real. And I think that realism and being real is what got us here. I think that people caught on to what we were doing. We wanted to shed light on what it meant to, showcase what America had to offer, or Canada had to offer in the outdoors. And like I said, with Banded, these walks of life, they all enjoy the outdoors. It's the common denominator. It's not me. It's not anybody that's done it as a celebrity. It's Mother Nature. When mallard ducks are doing what mallard ducks do in the sunshine, they make everybody drop to their knees. And you could be the biggest singer in the world. I hunted with Zach Brown. He sells out Fenway Park, 50,000 people. But when he's in Arkansas putting on waders, he cannot wait to get under a tree and kick the water and watch a dog do what a dog does and watch those mallard ducks. And I really think that that's what it came down to, is I got a platform that I was able to showcase what we really loved. And I was able to be introduced to these guys. And when they saw that we did it right, or they felt that we did it right and did it real, they respected what we did. And obviously we respected what they do. I would never go into the octagon with Cody Stamen and fight him. I'll go train with him. I'll play pickleball against him. But
pickleball?
Yeah,
that's
I love pickleball.
Thing?
I'm addicted, and he got me into pickleball. So all
okay, that's just so weird.
The you could talk about pickleball till we're blue in the face, but the bottom line is this. There is a mutual respect, and we all respect God, the man upstairs, Mother Nature, and what they provide to us on a daily basis. We are so blessed to do this, and it doesn't matter how famous you are. Ducks and a deer and a turkey will humble you in a heartbeat if you already don't have humility. So Cody's one of the most humble human beings I've ever met. And when you watch him train and what he looks like going into the octagon and his success in the octagon in the UFC, he's just an unbelievable human being, and I'm proud to call him a friend.
Well, what keeps bringing you back to Wisconsin, though, Chad? You travel the world to hunt, and you hunt in some of the best spots in the country every year, every month of every season that's open for waterfowl. Why do you keep coming back to Wisconsin?
The easy answer is Rebecca Clayfish. she's the nicest person in the world, and she deals with you know who's sitting here on the microphone. But I think it comes down to the people, the community, and what Wisconsin's all about. I'm a lover of vintage, and I'm a lover of culture. And when you can pull into a gravel parking lot and it says Friday Night Fish Fry, we don't have that where I'm from. Yeah. When you see cheese supper curds clubs and dairies and supper clubs and the beer and Bob Uecker and the Brewers and the Bucks and the Green Bay Packers and Lambeau, and then on top of that you put all these lakes and these walleyes and these turkeys and these ducks and geese and deer and everything that this state has to offer, it's one of the coolest places on earth. But it comes down to the community, the people, the attitude, the personality, the camaraderie, and the conversing. I told you, at the Concord Inn the last 3 years, every time I've walked in there, the owner John comes up and he doesn't shake my hand and say, hey, would you like a drink? He comes up and hugs me and says, thank you for coming into the Concord Inn. And he appreciates that. And it's just, that is so few and far between in the world today, to get that realism and that transparency and that honesty. And I think that that's what, it every day showcased in the state.
I don't know if I'm proud of this or not, but I am 1,000% a hugger. And it every time I go and meet someone else that's from a different state, I'm like, hey, nope. Hey, how's it going?
You know,
hug them.
I think there was a period a little bit ago where we were kind of afraid to express ourselves in that way. And I think Wisconsinites, especially with some of the cultures that has settled here, you know, the Italian and European cultures that are very huggy, very touchy. I mean, even kissing the cheeks happens in very many places throughout Wisconsin. And I think that lends itself to the term Midwest nice and Wisconsin nice. And you know, that is not what's going on in the Octagon.
Very aggressive hugging.
The Midwest nice thing doesn't really go well in my career
path. Hey, buddy.
We're doing the opposite of Midwest nice.
I'm
going
to tell you something. I want to get into what you like to hunt and what you brought, you know, what the commonality is between your lifestyle and the hunting lifestyle, because I think to have a UFC fighter, UFC fighting is something that is very raw. It's a very visceral sport. Mm-hmm. It is smash mouth. I mean, and I think that's one of the things we like about Green Bay football, the traditions of Lombardi, Bart Starr, Brett Favre. I mean, we are kind of a smash mouth football club, but I have been visiting with you just in the few short hours I've even met you. You are a very humble, kind, kind of almost soft-spoken, but very intelligent person. And what I'm curious to know is how your personality and persona is able to turn into what it does inside of an octagon or a ring, where the actual winner of this bout is who can physically, literally physically, dominate the other person. Is that tough as a person?
I think a lot of people have a common misconception of how a fighter is going to act outside of the ring. They think they're aggressive. They think, honestly, I think a lot of people assume that we're all dumb. I mean, I graduated college in 3 years. I might be an anomaly in fighting, but I think that fighting humbles you in a way that really nothing else in life can, because you're being, I mean, if I have a bad day at the office, it happens in front of my family. It happens in front of everyone who knows me. It's a horrible experience, and it humbles you in a way that life can't. You know, if you have a bad day at the office, it's probably between you and a few other employees or people that work under you, you know. But for me, it's, I do this in front of everyone I've ever met. So it humbles you in a way that really nothing else can. So, I mean, it's tough to be a proud and arrogant person. Obviously, I think a lot of people have like a persona that they put on when the camera gets on them. I'm not one of those people. I don't believe in it. I think being authentic is always the best way to be, on or off camera. But I think you would be really surprised at how kind and gentle MMA fighters are, really. I mean, some of the best human beings I've met in my entire life were fighters.
You said something to me, and this show actually does get below the surface. We like to peel the onion from time to time, but you said something to me on the car ride here that I thought was one of the most insightful things I've ever heard about a job. And I want you to share that with us, because when you said that, it made me think of what life is actually like when you do make it about honesty versus posturing and strategy.
Yeah. I think what I said on the car ride over was the reason I fell in love with fighting so fast and so easily is because I'd been in the business world most of my life. My parents owned a restoration company, so I'd kind of dealt with people in sales and done that most of my life. And you never really know what people's intentions are. You know, when you're going into a business situation, when you're, you know, someone smiles and shakes your hand, there's still always kind of like that looming, like, I'm not really sure what your intentions are. When I go into the cage and fight someone, I have no question of what their intentions are. When I'm preparing to fight someone in a cage, I know what my intentions are going to be. You know what I mean? And I know what his are. So I think fighting is just like an honest form of competition. There's no faking it. There's no shortcuts. There's no cheating it. And it's just...
Jake Paul fakes.
Like I said, yeah. But it's just like I said, like right before we got on air, like I said, like, are you nervous? And I'm like, no, like, you know, fighting turns the volume so far up and, you know, for that moment in life that everything else kind of seems like the volume is turned down. So like, there's really not too many situations outside of maybe killing a duck or a goose that really get me too excited. Or
how important is hunting in your life? How important is spending time in the outdoors? Because when you have to gather the intensity you do in order to do what you do for a living, you need an outlet.
Yeah.
Yeah. How important is that outlet to you? And what's your advice to those as to how the outdoors can literally bring peace to a human being?
Yeah, I think hunting is the most grounding spiritual thing. And then you do it amongst people that you care about and people that you respect. It's just a beautiful thing. I can't really think of anything that is more like unwinding and relaxing than hunting with your friends.
Man, I get so jacked up on this show, Danielle. And then there are moments that become kind of pensive where you look inside yourself and realize that every single person who's listening to us, everybody in the state of Wisconsin, has this resource literally outside of their front door to take what Wisconsin has to offer and somehow utilize it to their own benefit for peace, for prosperity, for food, for entertainment, for humor. We are just absolutely lucky in this state. We're blessed. I mean, people overuse the word blessed. I think we are lucky to be living where we are. And today shows me, you know, this show is not political. And we're seeing such a rise right now in the amount of hunters who are, number one, women, age 18 to 35, are the fastest growing group of new hunters. And we're seeing political philosophies being pushed aside for natural organic harvest. And having the difference and dichotomy of people we have in the studio with us right now just goes to show you, take the time to get to know the human being. Mm-hmm. Take the time to say to someone, do you want to spend time with me in the outdoors? Get to know them. If you disagree with them philosophically, maybe you get a chance to have that conversation down the road. This is why Raised in Wisco has got to be part of your life, and this is why Wisconsin Outdoors is mandatory for you.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Wisconsin, this is Raised in Wisco. I'm your host, Joel Clayfish, alongside Danielle Fairman.
Hello.
This studio is jam-packed, and I think it's about 472 degrees Kelvin in here.
Definitely is.
Do you know what the Kelvin scale is? Do you remember that from high school, Danielle?
Our old producer.
No, that was Calvin. Kelvin is a scale of measurement for stuff that's too hot that we can actually measure with Fahrenheit. It doesn't matter. It's an old trivia question. What a show it's been so far. How exciting. We've got a star-studded cast today. Tuffy Stone, six-time World Barbecue Champion Pitmaster Denny Reed from Maryland, inventor of Camo Space, Cody Stamen, UFC featherweight fighter, and quite an interesting and intellectual and kind of a deep dude. Appreciated that as well. And Chad Belding, who is the national host of The Foul Life in town, in Wisconsin, doing the travel Wisconsin stuff. We're going to a Packer game. We're going to be talking to Leroy Butler. I'm so jazzed about that.
Look at you go.
I can't even. And, Lieutenant Governor Sarah Rodriguez is coming to our home. And she's going to do a segment with us for the show.
Oh, that's very
nice. I'm so excited about it. We got government. We got food, we got social media, and we have UFC fighting.
Woo!
I mean, if
you
I put
probably
a ring
arm wrestle
up in
him.
The back, I should not arm wrestle him. I would love to see Chad Belding arm wrestle him because Chad Belding's arms are actually fairly large.
Oh, are they?
I'm not kidding.
Not really. They're not compared to Cody.
Well, I'm sure not, but compared to me. Oh my gosh. You know,
I was going to say I'll beat you in pickup.
Danielle, what do I always say at the end of the day this show
is?
It's
a cooking show.
This show is a cooking show because
we have the best here.
Well, you know what? There's not one person on this earth, whether you're regardless of philosophy, that can dispute the fact that we all have to eat.
Yes,
that's
yes,
it.
We do.
That's all there is to it. And, you know, I get to come back from Europe and tell some stories about how they take food and treat food and sitting down and eating. And in this country, I think we also really appreciate coming together for the meal. And I could not, if I had all the time in the world, write a better script as to someone who could do our cooking segment of the show better than Tuffy Stone, who's a six-time world barbecue champion pitmaster. Tuffy, I mean, I don't mean to totally put the pressure on, but I kind of do.
Pressure's on.
Talk to us about a cooking segment.
Okay, so you always do a recipe, but I want to really talk about a process or a method because we can apply this to a lot of different foods that we want to cook. Some of my guiding lights, things that are really important to me when I'm cooking barbecue or grilling, and I started off in a French kitchen getting yelled at by Chef Alain, and he had a term, it's a French term called mise en place. And basically it's to be organized, to have all your tools in the right place. I don't care if we're in the field hunting or we're fishing or we're in the kitchen cooking, being organized is going to make that process a lot more enjoyable. So when I get outside and I'm grilling or I'm barbecuing or I'm smoking, first of all, I'm going to start with the best meat that I can afford. I'm looking for well-marbled meat. These meats are going to, when it's well-marbled and you have that good intramuscular fat, it's going to render out and it's going to make for a nice, juicy bite. When it comes to seasoning, fresh rubs, I want, you know, if I'm going to spend 4 hours babysitting a rack of ribs, I want fresh ground black pepper. I want fragrant spices. I want to put the right amount of seasoning. The bigger the cut of meat, the more rub I put on there. The thinner the cut, the less. I'm going to have a clean pit. I'm going to have a clean grill. I do not subscribe to the flavors from the previous cook, adding better flavor to the next thing you cook. I'm always going to have a clean grill, sharp knives, good wood, good charcoal, and then doneness. I am going to hit the perfect texture every time. If it's a steak, I'm going to get it to where it's a nice medium rare for me. If you like it, cook more, cook it more. Resting these meats is going to allow this meat to cool down and for that juice to stay in there and make for a better bite. When it comes to saucing, always cook your meat till it's tender and done and then sauce at the end. Barbecue sauces have sugars in them, and if it get too hot, they'll burn on you.
Wow. I think you just
Hot dog.
I want you to, Danielle, it's
Hi,
all right.
Sorry.
It's
what are we talking about over here?
It's going to be all right, Danielle. Producer Jess is just shaking
her
head.
Exciting.
I just want to point that out.
It is dinner time.
It is. And when it is not coincidence that Tuffy Stone's nickname is the professor, because you literally have a poetic way to describe things. When you described the way to cook, I followed that as a person who's not experienced in smoking and barbecue. Yeah,
he
unbelievably
took notes.
We've got an MMA UFC fighter taking notes. Tuffy Stone. And I don't blame him. When you explain it that way, honestly, everything you said makes total and utter sense. What is the hardest part of that?
Cleaning the grill.
Learning the doneness. I mean...
Give us a key to learning the doneness.
You know, a good thermometer can help a lot, and you can find all your... when it comes to barbecue, when it comes to like things like pork shoulder or brisket or ribs and things like that, we can just take a skewer, and if you slide it into the meat and you feel like you got to push and that meat's resisting, it's not tender enough. So you just want it to slide in there with ease. When it comes to steaks and pork chops, that's a little bit more technical.
Real quick.
Yes, sir.
Tell me something we're going to eat this week. I'm so excited.
Smoked and lacquered duck with a honey Zinfandel reduction.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Sounds very barbecue-like, doesn't it?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Romance Hour, where Joel Clayfish courts his food for a week and finishes with lacquered duck. I can't wait. That sounds so fantastic. What an unbelievable... Hey, thank you for laughing back in the studio, Jess. You know that's one of my goals every time.
You got it.
What an incredible show. My dear friend, Chad Belding with The Foul Life is here. Get to spend the rest of the week with him hunting, eating, celebrating, watching Wisconsin sports, spending time in the outdoors. Denny Reed, you are an awesome dude, and I'm so excited about Camo Space. If you're not on Camo Space and you love the outdoors, get on it. Super easy to use. Post your pictures. Share your stories and adventures. Cody Stamen, what a great dude you are, man. I'm thrilled to have you here with us here in Wisconsin. I really appreciate it. And of course, Tuffy Stone wrapping it all up for us on the culinary front, which just plain makes me happy.
Very happy.
I really want to shout out to Mike and Peyton, who are the photographers in the studio with us today. Civic Media, you can listen to us on every Civic Media station throughout Wisconsin, 11 a.m. Saturdays. This is Raised in Wisco. What an exciting show. We love you were with us. We'll see you next week.
Thank you, Travel Wisconsin.
The national news cycle never stops, but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.